This is a smoke piece. Smoke piece. Only I'll know if I skip parts, or leave parts silent, or ad-lib, or improvise. You will know if I've gone off script, if you ask to see this piece written at a later time over email, or hard copy, or original transcript, audio cue, / guide. The earpiece. It's a TV thing. It's a club thing. It's a Sydney thing. Danny, in our first conversation, mentioned that smoking used to be part of the performance atmosphere because of cigarettes. But how... Wait. I just had deja vu. I just had deja vu. And I am adding this to the recording. Because of cigarettes. And how that becomes a cultural and health standard varying from territory to territory. So in a way, the toxic smoke that was naturally occurring is unseen until banned. Interesting. To smoke, to preserve, to smoke, to poison, to freshen up on flux, smoke. Can I understand danger magic if I've never heard of danger music? Freshen up on danger music. An image stands out, a familiar image from my material world, from a pinboard of inspiration of articles and postcards, and artworks from friends. The connection to performance art is Chris Burden. An image co-opted by a band called Believe. An image that never made sense to me the whole time. I would say 4 years. So it's been 4 years since my band played with Believe in Oakland. 2013. The image only revealed itself when I saw a more high-res version of it with the shadows and the lights. It made sense. The image along was a document which I could not see. The image all along. The image all along was actually a document of which I could not see, because I did not know what I could see, what was there. Through the Night Softly, 1973. Smoke and thoughts of Oakland. Haze. Recently, I underwent fire warden training, and the best way to survive is to follow your nose. Why would we create works that put ourselves in danger or take away our agency? Why try to? Toxic objects under fire become toxic smoke. And then the toxicity from the object into the air, forming a toxic smoke. There has never been a more dangerous time to be in accidental fire. Due to the toxic nature of all the materials that we're surrounded by every day, more than ever before. Danger moving from office furniture into toxic smoke. And the danger point being when the toxic smoke moves into your body and interacting with our lung function. When burning an object, it does not disappear. When burning an object, it does not disappear. It transforms into matter. It already knows what matter to turn into. It has no agency of what matter it wants to move to. To perform in a smoke space, a nude space, a normal space. Thank you to Danny for the conversations. Gently let the smoke kiss your body. Performance once finished transforms into a memory, a document, the remnants of an idea, an illustration in your mind, or a mechanism for connection. And then in turn these items transform again at a later time, informing and shaping until they find a spot to rest. Sound enters the ears and goes into the body and turns into a reference, a type of data. Memories are not matterless, neither are thoughts. They are material as the organs in our body. What happens when a person no longer can warrant what they do with their body or where they can take it, but their memories and thoughts are intact? Parts of their agency are missed or unseen, unexpressed, or unable to be noted. Their agency is in flux. Some people are like smoke, not matter. They don't participate in the city the way you must. They wander, strict migration patterns through the city, inhabiting the creases and waiting areas of oversized public bathrooms where they can be alone. Not alone, but observed, and not interacted with, but acknowledged. But then you can't really guarantee that. She reminds everyone who passes by her of her presence through passivity and lingering. Do you feel the city is a negative volume you're a part of? Or do you gently walk on its surface, making less impact than others, than people with more power, money, and privilege than you? Do you use your voice to make impact? Smoke, unconscious, smoke, all filling, theatrical, presenting the trick after the trick, trace. The smell remains. Haze, searching, believing, waiting to clear, lingering. The aftermath, it's temporary. Fog. It's good, you don't have to think it through, it's just a bit of fun. Fog. It's longer lasting. Probably? Dissolves quickly yet longer lasting? Close to the ground? Close to the mountain vibe? No trace, no smell? It was teacher's idea to use an earpiece, it was too dark to read from a text, to recite from the ear, not the eye. Thank you for this suggestion, teacher. This is an earpiece. This is an earpiece. Thank you, Kate. She's lent me the smoke machine that's filled the room with smoke, and there are approximately a number of people in the space. The number may waver depending on the interest, and the numbers may, you know, move up and down in the smoke recital. Grandma did an elocution, did recitals as an elocution teacher, but I never asked her whether they were her texts or ones that she owned or written by other people. I didn't know then. I didn't know there were famous women poets. I couldn't see it. I didn't know about Fluxus as a child. I didn't, well, they existed then, but I didn't see it because I didn't know. Her performance space was in a private domestic environment primarily. And as the smoke gently kissed my face, she said the best cigarette, taking a drag, is after a Chinese meal. And when the smoke appeared, I became an inversion of myself. I'm in flux of the foreground and the background, or a bit of both. It just kind of softens and becomes temporarily visible, or I guess some parts become more material depending on what part they're attached to. The talent meshes with the background, with the wall. Really try to see the smoke. Smoke recital. This is a smoke piece. Joel, thank you for your text. Oh, smoke, the institution and women. Zoe Robertson really smacked me in the face to smoke me out of apathy. Complicity. Name the ways in which you're passive now. On the interview on Canvas last Sunday, the smoke came up, but I flaked on it. I flaked on the detail. Do you find yourself the closest to it? And then right in the final moment, the final puff, it reveals itself to be elusive, puzzling. I nurtured you, I grew you, I added to you, I subtracted from you. It's good, you know, to think about it and to think it through. It's just a bit of fun. Smoke recital. This is a smoke piece. Oh, post disaster smoke. 9 and 9 haze. Can be faint. Temporary consciousness. Fog. Emotional blockage, no agency. You have to wait for fog to pass, or to last. This is, this falls as my recital, thank you very much.